Hello, my dear students. Let's continue the story in the kingdom of fools. So in the previous part, you've read that the king and the minister, they were fools. So the king had to punish the rich merchant because his house wall fell on the thief. So he died on the spot. That's why he had to punish to the rich merchant. So the king ordered a stake to be made ready for the execution, but they found that the rich merchant was too thin to be properly executed on the stake. So instead of punishing the rich merchant, they started finding a fat man to fit the stake. So who was that fat man? Yes, the disciple was caught. Do you remember the guru and his disciple? Yes, the same disciple was caught and he was presented in front of the king. So when he was caught, so he was just crying that what have I done wrong? I am innocent. So it was not the fault of disciple, but they were making everything ready to put the disciple on death. So what happens then? So at that time, when the disciple was caught, he remembered his guru's words that one day his guru told him that this is a city of fools, that you don't know what they'll do to you next. So he remembered. So while the king and the minister, they were waiting for the death of the disciple, so the disciple, he prayed to his guru in his heart. So as the disciple's guru, he could see everything in a vision. He had some magical powers, so he listened to his disciple's voice. So he came to save his disciple. So the disciple remembered his guru's words and he prayed in his heart. So the guru arrived to save the disciple. So what happens? So when the guru came there, he told the king that, "Oh, wisest of the kings, who is the greater, the guru or the disciple?" So he asked, the guru asked the question to the king that who is greater, the guru is the greater or the disciple is the greater? So what was that? So what happens if the king, he answered that, "Of course, guru is the greater." So the guru said that, "Put me to death first." So that's why they started, the guru and the disciple, they started fighting for death. The guru said that, "I am the greater, then put me to death first." And the disciple said that, no, "Put me to death first, not him." So these things were happening, and the king, he was very much puzzled by the behavior, and he asked the guru that why do you want to die? So at that time, the guru, he told the king that there's some mystery here, and he told the king that if he promised to put him to death first, then he would tell the king about that mystery. So what was that mystery? The guru told the king that whosoever dies on the stake first will be reborn as the king, and the next who will die next will be the future minister of the country. Yes, that's why. So the king, he was very much fool, and on the other side, the guru, he was very much wise. So he played a trick like that. So he was playing that game. So the time, the king was very much confused. So he didn't want to lose his kingdom. So that's why he postponed the execution to the next day. So the king, he was thinking in his mind that if he would die, then he would be the future minister of the kingdom. That's why he didn't want to let the guru and his disciple die. Instead of that, he wanted to die himself and his minister, so that they would be the future king and the minister of the same kingdom. So they postponed the execution for the next day. What happened then? So the king and the minister, they went secretly to the prison. Yes, at night they went secretly to the prison. And what did they do? So they released the guru and his disciple, and instead of hanging them to the death, they themselves sat on the stake, and they themselves died. And then what happens? The king and the minister, when they were taken to the stake and they were executed, because nobody knew in the kingdom that they were the king and the minister, because everybody was thinking it was guru and his disciple. So the city was in total confusion. So when the king and his minister, they came in front of their dead bodies, came in front of the people. So the people, they were really surprised to see that. So the people, they said that we people need a king and a minister. So what they did, so they asked the guru and the his disciple to be the future king and the minister of the kingdom. Yes, so the guru, he took a little time to think on this matter, but disciple, of course, he didn't take much time to decide to be the minister of the kingdom. So from then on, nothing strange happened in that kingdom. So night would again be night. So they decided that night would again be night and day would again be day. So so everything, that they could get nothing for a doo-doo. So according to the things, they set the prices again. So everything was normal in that city. So it became like any other place. Anything other was happening in the other kingdoms. So it was the same. So yes, you heard that, you read in the story that how the foolish king and his minister, they were fools, and they, how did they want to manage the things foolishly, what strange things they did in the kingdom, and how they were not able to identify the man who was actually responsible for the death of that thief. So the people, they were blaming, the rich merchant was blaming the bricklayer was blaming the dancing girl was blaming another, the goldsmith, and this thing happens. And instead of hanging the person who's responsible for the death, they themselves died. They themselves wanted to be the future king and the minister of the kingdom. So that's why they did the same. So the people, they needed the wise guru, as the guru was very much wise. So the people decided that they would be the king and the minister of the kingdom. So these things happened. So I hope you understood. So you will try to do the question answers of the chapter yourself. You can write the summary of the chapter also. So we'll meet soon with another video of next chapter. Till then, take care. Bye bye.